Hello and welcome back to 3D creation with Blender. I'm Daniel Gordillo and this is the fourth video about remaking old files in newer Blender versions. This time I'm gonna talk about shape keys and rigging, and I hope you will find this useful in your workflow. Okay, first thing to do is to create the base shape key, and the second one. I'm using the Snap to Object option to place the 3D cursor in the center of the left eye. This shape key will contain the open left eye. Every shape key can be mixed with the original shape, so we can animate the transition from close to full open eye. I'm using the 3D cursor as a pivot point to rotate the eyelid vertices. But I still need to move some of them one by one. Now we have the left eye shape key done, and we can duplicate and mirror it. We click on the Add New Shape key from Mix option, and then on the Mirror option. Okay, you can see I already have several shape keys made. We have upper left lip, upper right lip, lower left lip, lower right lip, eyelids and eyebrows. He's quite a handsome fella. Okay, let's create our armature, starting with our root bone. I'm duplicating the root bone to make the backbone, and then by pressing the E key, I extrude the neck and head. Then I duplicate the last one to make the jawbone. I will need more bones to control eye direction, among other things. But we'll get into that later. Now I'm parenting the mesh to the armature using the automatic weights option. As you can see, the automatic weight option assigns all the face area to the jawbone, so we need to adjust the vertex groups in weight paint mode. We need to erase all weights around the jaw area. The upper lip has to go too. Oops, those eyes need some fixing. Yes. If we find hard to reach areas, we can hide selected faces so we can get to the desired vertices. See, now I can paint those vertices inside the eye sockets. The lips weight need to be softened up. Okay, what I'm going to do next is to duplicate the jawbone to control the inside of the mouth. I need the jaw and lips to rotate a little more than the teeth and gums, so I came up with a little trick. The second jawbone copies the first bone X rotation, but it has a limit constraint. So the jaw rotates 5 degrees more than the teeth. And it makes the lips look like they have some extra movement. Okay, now we need to add a copy rotation constraint to the second jawbone and set the first jawbone to the bigger bone in this case as the target object. Now the teeth and gums mesh is parented to the second jawbone. I'm checking the rotation. Looks fine. I added another object, the tongue parented to 3 new bones in our armature. And a 3-bone system to change the eye direction. Both eyes have a damped track constraint, pointing toward a pair of bones, one for each eye, and a central bone to move the other 2 bones. As you can see, I have now custom objects as bones, and 2 more bones to move the clavicles and shoulders. In the next video, I will make some armor and clothes for our character, and decals to create war painting. Okay, that's all for now. Thank you for watching. And don't forget to subscribe. See you.